This is a period in Israel's history where certain judges called the shots, so to speak, and made decisions. But I underline that last verse because it describes America to the T. Verse 25, in those days there was no king in Israel. Every man did that which was right in his own eyes. Does that describe America or what? There was no king in Israel. That's what happens in your life when you don't have a king in your life. King Jesus, I'm talking about. You'll live a life of confusion and have no direction for your life. The message today I'm going to share about is discernment. Discernment. That was one place to go. Another place I want to show you is Isaiah 65 in verse 2, page 782. 782 will get you there. If you're using the Bible in the pew, we have them provided there for you. 782 will get you to Isaiah 65 in verse 2. Speaks of a similar situation. Well, look at verse 1. Verse 1 is good, too. We'll read that with verse 2. Chapter 65 of Isaiah, I am sought of them that ask not for me. I am found of them that sought me not. I said, behold me unto a nation that was not called by my name. And if you look in your side reference in your Bible, it'll say Gentiles. That's you and me. We're Gentiles. We're those that sought the Lord. In verse 2, I've spread out my hands all day on the rebellious people which walked in a way that was not good. And that last phrase, after their own thoughts. And now, back to page, to the Proverbs. We've got to go backwards a little bit to the book of Proverbs. 686, if you're still using the Bible in the pew. 686. Where at, preacher? Proverbs 2, verses 1 through 11. There's a number of verses there we're going to read, so I guess I'll just have you follow after me. My wife says I read too fast. Let's see if you can follow me. All right, verses 1 through 11. Chapter 2. My son, if thou wilt receive my words and hide my commandments with thee, so that thou incline thine ear unto wisdom and apply thine heart to understanding. Yea, if thou criest after knowledge and liftest up thy voice for understanding, if thou seekest her as silver, searchest for her as for hid treasures, then shalt thou understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. For the Lord God giveth wisdom, out of his mouth cometh knowledge and understanding. He layeth up sound wisdom for the righteous, he is a buckler to them that walk uprightly. He keepeth the path of judgment and preserveth the way of his saints. Then shalt thou understand righteousness and judgment and equity, yea, every good path. When wisdom entereth into thine heart, knowledge is pleasant unto thy soul. Discretion shall preserve thee. Understanding shall keep thee. Chapter 3, Proverbs, verse 5 through 8. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. Be not wise in thine own eyes. Fear the Lord, and depart from evil. It shall be health to thy navel, and marrow to thy bones. Then skipping a few verses to 13 through 24, same chapter 2. Happy is the man that finds wisdom, the man that gets understanding. For the merchandise of it is better than the merchandise of silver, and the gain thereof than fine gold. She is more precious than rubies, and all the things thou canst desire are not to be compared unto her. Length of days is in her right hand, and in her left hand riches and honor. Her ways are ways of pleasantness, and her paths are peace. She is a tree of life to them that lay hold upon her. Happy is every one that retaineth her. The Lord by wisdom hath founded the earth, by understanding hath he established the heavens. By his knowledge the depths are broken up, the clouds drop down the dew. Well, I just don't know where to stop. It just keeps going so good. So shall thy life be unto thy soul, and grace to thy night. Then shall thou walk in thy way safely, and thy foot shall not stumble. When thou liest down, thou shalt not be afraid. Yea, thou shalt lie down, and thy sleep shall be what? Sweet. What's that mean? What do you think that means? Take some next to night. Safe and restful sleep. Remember that commercial? That goes way back. What it means is when you have the peace of God living and ruling in your heart, you'll have rest. Stress will keep you awake all night, but He'll give you rest to your soul, and your sleep will be sweet. You won't need medication to sleep. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, what a blessing. What a blessing it is to just live and enjoy life. A wonderful week this week we had with our families and relatives getting together. Just had a wonderful day of Thanksgiving. And now back today with your people. Lord, you know what they have been going through this week. You know what each and every one's, how much is in their checkbooks. You know right to the cent what they have. You know, Lord, what they will need before they even ask. And Lord, I've asked you to speak to their hearts today. Use these lips of clay to let them know that you love them and you care for them. And you're interested in everything about them and their lives, their plans, and their pathways. You want to direct their lives because you love them so much. Perhaps it's been discussion this week. What shall I do, Lord? How shall I handle this situation? What shall I do? Father, I know you're going to answer that today. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody said, Amen. Amen. To this message by way of internet. I want to pray a little prayer for you. Father in heaven, I pray for each and every one that may tune in this message. Perhaps you're working a job that you're not able to be in church like we are here this morning. But I pray that this message will speak to your heart, will help you with life's decisions, will show you the path that you need to try, will show you the direction that you're seeking for in your life, will give your life meaning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. When's the last time you heard a message on discernment? Doesn't seem to be a very popular subject today. Certainly in our culture, we certainly need it. It seems like we're overloaded with information, but we're very short on insight. One click online can give you access to more information than any of our ancestors could have even imagined. Could you think about trying to explain the internet to your grandpa or grandmother if they were still with you? I remember when men went to the moon and I tried to explain it to grandpa that we put a man on the moon. He said, oh, yeah, he said, that little box can tell you anything. Referring to television. That little box can tell you anything. He said, did you see him go on the moon? I said, no. Well, then how do you know they put one man on the moon? Well, the television said, I told you that box will tell you anything. He went to his grave never believing in that. Can you imagine what he'd think with the internet? I remember when they would take the programs and music and services on the little cassette tape. And then he'd put it in that little machine and play it. He said, how'd he get all that on that little thing? How'd he do that? I said, I don't know, Grandpa. I don't know. Shook his head. It was too old. He couldn't grasp it. We have access to so much information. But how do we know what's true? Do you think knowing more today has made us any wiser? There's such a lack of discernment, it's everywhere. Lack of discernment causes overwhelming debt, unsolvable problems, emotional turmoil, strained relationships, and even right and wrong are up for grabs. So many people seem today have no focus on what is right or what is wrong. They just simply don't know. We certainly enter into that era of the judges.